Mason, and 10 weeks ago, I got bucked off a horse and landed on my head wearing a terrific helmet and cracked a couple vertebrae in my upper neck. I had also cracked a bone in my thumb, went home from the hospital with this and a cast. For my cast, they gave me 2 pages of instructions on how to take care of it. For this, nothing. So I've had to discover a lot of things, and a lot of people ask me, how do you sleep? Do you get to take that off at night? Well, no. It's kind of, you know, fixed firmly into your head with these little surgical pins. And they don't hurt that much, but certainly walking and moving around really helps make the pain get better, because the circulation just brings the endorphins out and makes you feel better. So I just thought I'd show you a little bit about my nighttime procedures. And you're going to need a lot of pillows if anybody ever needs to do this. This is the pillow that goes around the back of my neck, which fits underneath my hair and around the brace. That's so I have some support when I lay down. My sister-in-law gave me a crazy memory foam pillow, and I cut it apart and made one this size. I originally had made one this size that fit between the bars, but it was not comfortable. So memory foam is really a strong bit for putting pieces together. This little piece for under my chin was also a piece of memory foam pillow that I had, and I just cut the ends off of it. Then we have the pillow for the knees. Then we have, these are very handy little things, any of these neck thingies, because they can go in all kinds of places to hold you up. So then you put something on an incline, you rest yourself back, put your feet up. You want to have something under your elbows, because your arms just fall back and that's very uncomfortable. And honest and truly, the easiest way to sleep is with a pillow here, so your arms are here. But wait, there's one more thing. When you're in this position and in this rig, your mouth falls open in the middle of the night, so you wound up with this incredibly dry mouth. So I take this little piece of memory foam wrapped in a bandana, wedge it under my chin so my mouth stays shut. You can't make this stuff up. It's too unbelievable. But the good news is, tomorrow, this thing comes off. So 10 and a half weeks, I've made it through, and I've done it by walking, doing exercises. When you lay on your back and you swing your knees from side to side, you're making a slight torquing of your spine. And this just creates early circulation in your body through all your muscles. So, you know, there's a lot of controversy about whether you stretch before you exercise and all this stuff. What you're really trying to do is oxygenate your muscles a little bit, as well as just get fluidity. So I found, even when I was just being a rider, not being hurt, that doing those exercises would tell me where I was sore that day, and how maybe my left hip was a little sore than my right, or my low back, or between my shoulder blades. And the whole point of those is to move your limbs around in different ways so your spine moves ever so gently in a torquing, twisting fashion, which is very gentle and very easy to do. Okay, so regrettably, reading is pretty hard, which is very sad, because this is a long slog without being able to read books. But if you have a music stand, you can put the book almost at eye level. And almost always when you're sitting down, you have to be propped up from behind, and it feels good because it supports your lower back. So depends on what your vocal length is. If you need glasses, it's kind of tricky, but it works out. My focus is on the biomechanics of horses and rider as a trainer and teacher. So I produced a DVD years ago called Focus on Flexibility, which turns out to have been very helpful for me in my recovery and gave me a lot of understanding about how the body moves. And then my book, It's Never Too Late. In doing a lot of the research for this book, I really learned a lot about the human body, which has helped me immeasurably to visualize where I've been hurt and how I'm going to heal that area. And my next project is going to be an ebook where I'm going to be able to write and encapsulate bits of video, which thank goodness are already in the can, because I'm not going to be doing a lot of riding in the short term. But I'll probably be back to riding. I'm still teaching, obviously, and enjoying the heck out of that. So tomorrow's the big day.